Business is well and truly bursting back to life. The reopening of Sydney's Sea Life Aquarium, a boost for parents and children alike.
Thrilled to be back and to be able to come and see all the animals.
A shark and a snapping turtle.
The animals missed the company too.
Pig absolutely loves attention. And so having you guys back is going to make his day.
It's been a tough few months, but we're so excited to getting back to doing, you know, what we do best.
The state's new premier and former treasurer offering businesses an economic boost.
Two additional $25 vouchers. We know that these vouchers have injected close to $500 million into the New South Wales economy.
The vouchers can be used at both dining and entertainment venues from December as the government bids to bolster the state's COVID recovery. It's also injecting $66 million into an alfresco dining package to encourage businesses to take advantage of the COVID-safe outdoors.
It's been a great help because that's money directly pushed into the business that otherwise we wouldn't have had.
The Premier says he's confident the state will reach the 80% double dose target this weekend. What freedoms come with that milestone will be discussed at a cabinet meeting tonight, including if travel will be allowed between Greater Sydney and regional areas.
There are reports that regional travel could be delayed by at least a week, including to areas like Wilcannia, which today marked 15 days without a COVID-19 case. Indigenous leaders warn welcoming travellers too soon could have dire consequences.
We're very fragile, you know. Our communities are very fragile and exposed. So to open it up totally would be without communication, engagement and some agreements would be disastrous, you know.
Danielle Robertson, SBS World News.